AFMC is really known.
And also make sure to unmute.
Welcome to this episode of AFMC TV. I'm Robin Ledbetter. Thank you for joining us. Today I have with me Christine Brett, and she is the Director of Labor and Delivery and ER for Willow Creek Women's Hospital. Christine, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me. I'm excited to be here.
Me too. So tell me about the importance of postpartum care.
I think postpartum care is so important and often neglected. I think people focus on the pregnancy and getting the baby here, and then people put all their attention on the baby, and the moms get left behind a lot. So we really want to highlight the importance of taking care of moms in this critical time period too, so that they're there to be able to safely take care of their babies.
And complications don't end at the pregnancy, right?
Absolutely not. There are several postpartum complications that healthcare workers and moms and the public all need to be aware of. So postpartum complications can last up to a year, and they can include anything from, we've seen the depression, anxiety, psychosis. There can be preeclampsia, eclampsia, hemorrhages, a lot of things that could influence a mom's health in that 1 year postpartum.
You've mentioned, as we've discussed before, that pregnancy is not a social history, it's a medical history. Explain what that means.
So I think people think, yeah, I had a baby and now I have this cute baby at home. But people don't realize that you actually went through a medical procedure. No matter which type of delivery you had, it's going to change your medical history. You now have different hormones, your body has changed. And if you did have a cesarean section, that is a major abdominal surgery. So just giving it the medical respect that it deserves, I think, could be very game-changing for maternal health.
And you have created a really unique but simple program with a bracelet. Tell me what that is.
So at the end of March, we started this program where we give all moms this simple silicone bracelet that says, I gave birth at Willow Creek, with the instruction to wear them for 1 year postpartum. So the idea is for it to act as a medical alert bracelet. We've been doing education with local EMTs and all the emergency rooms in the area, even ones that don't have obstetric care at their facility, especially those ones. We want to make sure that they are keeping an eye out for these bracelets. So if a patient presents with postpartum complications, that it's in the diagnostic realm that they're considering these postpartum issues and not just general medical issues.
And they should wear it for a certain amount of time?
The education provided is for 1 year postpartum, so that ERs can also be aware of if someone is coming in with very vague complaints and they've been repeatedly visiting ERs, that could be a sign of postpartum depression or postpartum anxiety that people aren't speaking in clear terms about. But maybe if you see someone, you know, saying, oh, I just have a headache or my back hurts, and they're going to the ER a lot, this bracelet can signify to the healthcare team, maybe we need to get this mom some other resources.
And why is the first year after delivery so important? Like, what are some of the things you mentioned, precocious, some things that could be problematic?
Yeah, so the mental health aspect obviously is a big one, especially in today's climate. So looking for those signs and symptoms of postpartum depression, postpartum anxiety, and postpartum psychosis. I think we've seen a lot of increased attention, but I think we can always do better, right? So we need to be looking out for those types of complications. Postpartum hemorrhages can happen up to a year postpartum. Even, you know, 6 weeks out, you think you're all good, and then all of a sudden you are bleeding. And if you're unable to speak for yourself when you get taken to an ER, this bracelet is going to allow that medical team to treat you appropriately. Same thing, eclampsia, that means you're having a seizure related to a pregnancy complication. So if you're seizing and you go in, the treatment for that seizure, again, is very different than if you're having an epileptic seizure or a seizure of some other origin. So we want to make sure that there's no delay in that treatment care so that people are taken care of appropriately.
And it does make a big difference with mental health. We hear about that a lot now in the news. So how does the bracelet address mental health awareness?
Absolutely. Even a friend, even a colleague, a coworker, if they notice some changes in behavior, the people in your circle are going to be the first ones to notice those mental health changes. And, you know, if you are not showering, if you're not eating regularly, so even this to a spouse or a partner could be a reminder, just a visual reminder, like, she did just have a baby. Maybe there is something going on. Maybe we need to ask more questions to really help get people the help they need.
How does this help underserved populations?
People who live in rural areas who do not have, you know, they may be an hour and a half away from a hospital that delivers babies. This allowing that patient to go to their nearest hospital, that even if it doesn't have OB capabilities, we are training people in those ERs to recognize symptoms for some obstetric emergencies and what they can do at their facility to stabilize this patient and get them to a facility like us where we can take appropriate care of them.
You know, and Arkansas faces several maternal desert areas. How does this affect maternal care?
I would love to see this program rolled out across the state, across the country. We recently drove to New Orleans from Northwest Arkansas, and just driving and realizing the time that passes between hospitals, and then we're Googling, does this hospital deliver babies? And where do these patients go and what do they do? So any health literacy education that we can provide to get people in these deserts appropriate care. So again, just a simple little bracelet can indicate to a facility that doesn't deliver babies that maybe we need to get them to a more appropriate facility.
Well, I think it sounds like a unique, a really cool and unique idea that affects so many in our state. So to learn more about the bracelets and this new initiative, what can healthcare providers do?
So you can feel free to call us at Willow Creek. Our nurse navigator's phone number is 479-684-3204. And my office number, I'm also happy to talk to anyone about this, is 479-684-3245.
Well, Christine, it was such a pleasure talking to you. I've learned so much about the bracelet program and what you guys do at Willow Creek. And it's such a pleasure and an honor to learn more about this program. Thank you so much for sharing your story.
Of course, I'm happy. And anything we can do to help support women in Northwest Arkansas and Arkansas and in this country have birth safely, that's what we want to do.
Well, that's it for this edition of AFMC TV. I'm Robin Ledbetter. Thanks for watching and have a great day.